How could I not believe in God? Look how much I gained after everything I lost. How could I not place my trust in something that knows us better than we know us? How could I not pray and give thanks after all of those mistakes He still gave me chance after chance? You see, before birth it was darkness, and after death we always thought it'd be the same. But the soul is separate from the body, and after life the soul shall remain. They say then unto God we shall return, as is from Him we all came. Some question, does He even exist? What's understood need not be explained. But we ain't people of understanding, we're people of living and ignoring. Let's ignore the reality so we can enjoy the fantasy. Fantasy's all it is when you don't enjoy it actually. A people of pretenders, let's pretend we're filled with happiness, smiling on the outside while inside filled with sadness. How can you find peace in the heart? How can you find peace in the heart if you don't have a connection with the one who created the heart? We can worship the clothes and we can worship the cars, but we don't worship the one who created the moon and the stars. It's crazy when you look at life. I grew up poor, so I was generally unhappy, and the media let us believe that success was in materials and money. So we praise those who have the most, we look up to them and label them celebrities, wishing we had a life like theirs, while they're wishing they had a life of simplicity. They spend a life trying to avoid the cameras, we spend our time trying to be in front of them. We praise them for their beauty and their talent while we ignore the God that created them. That's like thanking the waitress that brings the meal, but disregarding the chef. That's like praising the beauty of a building, but not the architect. You're amazed by the brain of the designer of an aeroplane. What about the designer of a bird or a brain? Sad reality, we become a nation that don't worship the creator, but we worship his creations. Have you ever been to the mountains? Go to the mountains, stand upon them, ponder on them. Look at the clouds that hover over them. Look at the sky, try and understand the life of the birds that fly. Look at the sea, watch the fish swim, the sharks fin and the jumping dolphin. Listen to the roaring, sounds of the jungle, elephants and lions. Anyone with intelligence can see the signs. Animals and mankind, heavens and earth. How could two people come together and bring about a child's birth? Mad, now what's that life worth? They just play, study and work, but that play ain't even satisfying. We're all depressed and unsatisfied, and this work ain't even sufficient. Nobody's content with their current position, continuously searching for more and more and more, but we don't know what we're searching for. I made a study about what we study. It troubled me, cause honestly most of it was worthless. That's why we live our life without knowing our true purpose. They taught us science but didn't teach us science. They taught us history but didn't teach us history. That was all from the wrong perspective and too selective. I didn't learn religion in RE, they can't modify me. I'm more Malcolm than Michael. I stay with a character delightful, but the brain's always serious. Focus on what's in front of us, seeing past the nights and days, looking ahead to when we fall and then raise. I can't live without praise. Don't praise me, praise the one that made me. Praise the one that made it all. None of this could ever come about by chance. Look at the planets and the galaxy. This world would end, be their one collision, but they orbit the sun in a perfect fashion. Imagine life without God. Imagine life without God. We was broke, prayed for money, then the door knocked. We were scared, prayed for safety, then the car stopped. And when it didn't, we kept the faith and saw the benefits another day. We trust God's wisdom, so we accept His decision. They question and end up in deeper depression. Don't be like them. You are the company of your friend. The truth is, we don't want to believe it. We're scared of what we don't know. We're comfortably lost. We don't want to ruin it, and we would be forced to if we'd seen it. And the truth is, we see it every day, but we blind play, like that's the easier way. How can you not praise the God that created everything you admire, the ruler of the heavens and the fire? You stay silent when the universe is expanding, can't count the stars or fathom your surroundings. You make noise when your favorite player scores a goal, but what's that compared to the universe and a black hole? You act like God's power is just a made up story. Split the atom and you'll understand His glory. God is perfect without any flaw. Gratitude, forgiveness, forever opening mercy's door. Even if He gave you nothing, even after everything, He didn't give you nothing more. He is still worthy of worship through good times and the hardship. Humble yourself before you get humbled. God is the greatest without any doubt. Don't act like you created yourself inside and out. Everything comes from Him. Our wealth, this world, everything. Don't be blind, look how we're designed. Our eyes, our hair, four fingers and a thumb. The heart, the liver, the lungs. God's plan is better than anyone's. When turbulence hits a plane, or that boat hits a wave, watch how fast they call His name. After everything they say, when life's at stake, even a disbeliever starts to pray. How can we not believe in God? Don't look at all the things we could have, look at everything we got. And when the night and day is over, and we're raised up, we return to Him, we face our Creator. Pray today, before it's too late.